There are winners and losers tonight after the state Supreme Court ruled against Dane County's health department. The clear winners are the schools that felt public health didn't have the authority to shut them down. But some worry that ruling could mean many of those schools will ultimately lose long after the pandemic is over. Amanda Quintana joins us to tell us why. Amanda?
Well, you might be thinking school is done or just about, and coronavirus is on its way out too. So why does this decision matter? Public health says you need to think beyond COVID, but for the lawyer arguing for religious protections, this is a win.
Court granted the relief that we asked for on the grounds that we asked for it. You know, a lawyer can't ask for much more than that.
For Rick Essenberg, president of Wisconsin Institute for Law and Liberty, today's Supreme Court decision wasn't a surprise. It says if schools need to close for a public health reason, the state can do that, but not local public health departments. So when Public Health Madison and Dane County shut down all schools in August, that was unconstitutional, and closing religious schools violated the religious freedom guarantee.
The plaintiffs in this case said, look, in-person instruction with all the appropriate safeguards is necessary for us to fulfill our religious mission as a school.
The ruling means local public health departments don't have the power to close schools for any type of outbreak. That worries PHMDC's director, Janelle Heinrich, who says it would block them from closing schools for measles, whooping cough, or the flu. Heinrich wrote it could hurt their ability to respond to any disease that might impact students, teachers, and school staff, and impacts families and friends beyond the walls of the school. So is that a legitimate concern?
I do cringe.
Epidemiologist Dr. Ajay Sethi says yes.
It's really important that our local public health officers, you know, have the ability and the authority to use science to decide, you know, how to protect the health of the public.
Sethi says stripping powers from the experts who are trying to protect the community could be dangerous. And it's local public health departments who are in constant communication with schools, so they know what decisions need to be made.
As a state in Wisconsin, we have a long history of the state health department relying on local health departments to be a part of that decision-making process and also to make local decisions. And when outbreaks occur, they're investigated by local health departments.
While some might think this decision took too long, Essenberg felt that it came pretty quickly. As for the private school students, they only missed a handful of days before the Supreme Court temporarily blocked public health's order just days after the lawsuit was filed in September.